Today we will show how to evaluate internal forces in trusses using the method of sections. As a revision, let us explain what is a truss. In a truss, every joint in the structure is a hinge, and no loads should exist in the spans between the joints. Concentrated loads are allowed only at the locations of the joints. When the above conditions are fulfilled, the structure will qualify as a truss. So if we cut the truss into two parts, only one internal axial force will appear at each cut member. The method of sections is based on cutting the truss into two parts, then applying the equilibrium equations on one of the parts to evaluate the unknown internal forces. Because we have only three equilibrium equations, in order to solve the internal forces, the cut section should only have three unknown internal forces. For the shown truss, if we worked on the left part and took the moment about point C, we will find that the internal forces F2 and F3 will pass through C and will not be included in the moment equation. So the moment equation will only have one unknown, F1, which can be evaluated. Next, we can evaluate F2 by applying sigma y equals 0 because F2 has a component in the y direction. After evaluating F1 and F2, F3 can be evaluated using the equation sigma x equals 0. Now that all the internal forces have been evaluated, we can apply the equilibrium equations on the right part of the truss to validate the results. Before working on examples, we need to establish the sign convention of the internal forces. The internal force in the truss member will be either compression or tension. If the forces in the members are pulling the two parts closer to each other, then the forces are tension. The tension forces are drawn emerging out of the joint and are assumed positive. If the forces in the members are pushing the two parts away from each other, then the forces are compression. The compression forces are drawn directed towards the joint and are assumed negative. Now let us look at an example. For the shown truss, we need to evaluate the internal forces in the marked members using the method of sections. As a first step, we evaluate the reactions. Next, because we need to work with the x and y components of inclined forces, we need to find their angle of inclination. In this problem, all inclined members have the same angle of inclination, which is evaluated to be 45 degrees. The most direct way to solve this problem is to cut through the members that need to be evaluated. So the truss is cut into two parts and will have three unknown internal forces in CD, FD, and FG. The forces are initially assumed tension and are drawn emerging out of the joints. If the calculations produce a negative value for any force, then the force is compression and its direction will be reversed. We start by working on the right part and take the moment about point D. We notice that the forces in CD and FD, as well as the 12 kN force, all pass through point D and will not be included in the moment equation. The equation will include two terms, YB multiplied by 4-meter arm rotating counterclockwise, positive, the force in FG multiplied by 4-meter arm also rotating counterclockwise, positive. Both terms must sum to zero, giving a value of negative 11 kN for the force in FG. Therefore, the force in FG is compression and should be reversed. Next, we apply sigma y equals 0. The force in FD will be included in the equation because it has a vertical component and will be the only unknown in this equation. Therefore, by solving the equation, sigma y equals 0, we evaluate the forces in FD to be positive 1.41 kN. So it is tension as initially assumed. Finally, we apply sigma x equals 0 to evaluate the force in CD, which is found to be positive 10 kN, tension. All requested internal forces have been evaluated. If we want, we can apply the equilibrium equations on the left part to validate the results. Let us look at another example. For the shown K-truss, we need to evaluate the internal forces in the marked members using the method of sections. First, we evaluate the reactions. Then we find the angle of inclinations of the inclined members. All inclined members have the same angle of inclination, theta. By inspecting the geometry, we evaluate cosine theta as 0.8 and sine theta as 0.6. If we cut through the members that need to be evaluated, as we have done in the previous example, we will find that we will have to cut through four members in order to cut the truss into two separate parts. So we will have four unknown internal forces, but we have only three equilibrium equations, which are not enough to solve these forces. To solve this problem, we need to evaluate at least one of the four unknown forces first, using a different cut section, before returning to solve the remaining unknowns in this cut section. Let us try the following special cut that goes through members CD, CF, FI, and IJ, as shown. This cut will also produce four unknowns, and we still only have three equilibrium equations as before, which will not be enough to solve all the unknowns. However, this cut has something special that will be a key for solving the problem. If we consider the left part and take the moment about point C, we will notice that the three internal forces in CD, FC, and FI all pass through point C and will not be included in the moment equation. So the moment equation will have only one unknown, which is the force in IJ, and can easily be evaluated. The moment equation will include four terms. YA multiplied by 4 meter arm rotating clockwise, negative. 3 kN vertical force multiplied by 4 meter arm rotating counterclockwise, positive. 4 kN horizontal force multiplied by 6 meter arm rotating clockwise, negative. And the force in IJ multiplied by a 6 meter arm rotating clockwise, negative. All terms should sum to zero, giving a value of negative 6.67 kN for the force in IJ. Therefore, it is compression and its direction should be reversed. By applying sigma x equals zero, the force in CD is evaluated to be positive 6.67 kN, so it is tension. Now we are left with the two unknown internal forces in FC and FI and only one equilibrium equation. So we will not be able to evaluate these forces from this cut. However, these forces are not requested in our problem. After the forces in IJ and CD have been evaluated, now we can return to the original cut that we made initially. Now this cut will have only two unknown internal forces in FD and FJ, and the three equilibrium equations will be more than enough to evaluate them. Let us consider the right part and start by taking the moment about point D. First, we will discuss the moment caused by the inclined force in FJ. To evaluate this moment, we need to find the arm of the moment, which is the perpendicular distance from point D to the path of the force as shown. To evaluate this distance, we need to work with some geometric relations. Instead, we can use the x and y components of the inclined force to make it easier to find the arm of the moment. However, be aware that the force components can be moved to any point on the path of the original force without changing the final outcome of the moment equation. We can use this to our advantage to place the components in a location that simplifies the solution. However, take care that both the x and y components should be moved together to the same location. By applying the moment equation, we will find that the vertical component of FJ, the forces in FD and CD, as well as the vertical 6 kN force, all pass through point D and will not be included in the equation. The moment equation will include four terms, YV multiplied by 4 meter arm, counterclockwise positive, 3 kN vertical force multiplied by 4 meter arm, clockwise negative, the evaluated force in IJ multiplied by 6 meter arm, clockwise negative, and the horizontal component of the force in FJ multiplied by 6 meters arm, counterclockwise positive. Solving the equation gives a positive 1.67 kN for the force in FJ, so it is tension. Finally, we apply sigma x equals 0 to evaluate the force in FD, which is found to be negative 1.67 kN, so it is compression and its direction should be reversed. Now all requested internal forces have been evaluated. If we want, we can apply the third equilibrium equation in this part or the three equilibrium equations on the left part to validate the results.